Assalamu alaikum, my dear students. Hope you are all well by the grace of Almighty Allah. Today, I am Shandida Rahman, assistant teacher of National Ideal English Version School, Deshi. Today, I am going to take a science class for the student of class 6. Our class number, lecture number is... Our class 6, subject science, term, half yearly exam 2021, topic, chapter 2, CQ 1 and 2, homework, CQ 2, C number, lecture number 9, homework number 7, teacher Shandida Rahman, and here is my contact number. If you need any problem or if you need, you can contact with me. Now, we will discuss creative question number 1 and 2. Now, let's start our class. Here is the creative question 1. A. What are invertebrates? Number B. Why is toad called amphibia? Explain. Number C. Write down the differences between the animals shown in figure A and figure number B. Discuss the importance of animal in figure B. You have to discuss the importance of animal figure number B. Now, we will answer what are invertebrates. The animals which do not have vertebral columns are called invertebrate. You know that animals are two types, invertebrate and vertebrate. The animals which have no backbone, they are called invertebrate, and the animals which have vertical column, they are called vertebrate. Number B, why is toad called amphibia? Explain. Answer, toad is called amphibia because they spend some parts of their life in water and some on the land. They do not have any hair, scales or feather on integuments. They have two pair of legs. Now you can ask me, what is the meaning of integuments? Integuments means outer part or outer layer of the of their body. They have two pair of legs. There is no nail on their phalanges. Phalanges means their finger. At the primary stage of their life cycle, the tadpole respires by gill, and at the adult stage, they respire by lungs. At the earlier stage, when they are baby, the tadpole respires by gill and they live in the water. And in the adult stage, they respire by lungs like us, and also they live in the land. So that's why toad is called an amphibian, because in the childhood it lives in the water and in adult stage it lives in the land. Now we will discuss question C. Write down the differences between of the animals shown in the figure number A and figure number B. Here is the figure of two fish. The organism in figure A is invertebrate animal and figure number B is vertebrate animals. Differences between the invertebrate and vertebrate animals are given below. Figure number A, here is the chart, figure number A and figure number B, and here is the differences of figure number A and figure number B. Figure number A, vertebral column is absent. Here in figure number A, their vertebral column is absent, but in figure number B, vertebral column is present. They have no skeleton. They don't have any skeleton. They have skeleton. They have skeleton. They have complex eyes. They have complex eyes, and they do not have any complex eyes. You know that complex eyes means more than one eyes, and simple eyes or simple eyes means there is only one eye. In number 4, they have antenna. In figure number A, they have antenna. This is antenna, and they don't have any antenna. In figure number A, has no tail. It has no tail. But in figure number B, it has a tail. Now question D, discuss the importance of animal in figure number B. You have to discuss the importance of animal which is shown in the figure number B. Figure number B, animal in figure number B is fish. All fishes belong to group named fishes. They live in water. Most of them have scales. Example, hilsa, rui, koi, etc. However, some of them have no scales. For example, mahu, shin, tengra, boal, etc. This kind of fishes don't have any scale. They use gills for respiration. They also have fins which they use to swim. Like this, they use these fins for swim. Fish is a source of protein. Some sea fishes carries a good number of minerals and vitamin A and vitamin D. Some fishes are the source of iodine. Fish provides such nutrients and micronutrients that are essential to cognitive and physical development, especially in children, and are an important part of healthy diet. Now, a day, fish provides more than 1 billion poor people with most of their daily animal protein. Poor people get their animal protein from the fish, and fish is very important because we get vitamin A and vitamin D from the fishes. Now we will discuss question number 2. At first we read the question. Here is in this picture, there is a picture of a tree, coconut tree, and here is a picture of a banyan tree. Number A, what are flowering plant? Number B, write down two characteristics of A. Write down the differences between A and B, and D number, write down the importance of A in your life. Now we will discuss what are flowering plants. Plants are two types. One kind is flowering plant and another kind is non-flowering plant. The plant, there are some plants that bear flowers and fruits. They are called flowering plant. They are called flowering plant, like mango, jackfruit. They are called flowering plant because they bear flower and also fruit. In answer B, write down the characteristic of A. Answer, in the stem as shown by the figure A is a monocot plant. Two of its characteristics are given below. Now you ask me, what is monocot plant? Monocot plants are the plants which have only one seed and there is no part of this seed. They are called monocot, and dicot means the seeds which divided into two parts, they are called dicot seed, like bean. Number one, stem is unbranched. Two of its characteristics are given below. Stem is unbranched. In coconut tree, their stem is not branched and leaves with parallel venation. Their leaves are in parallel venation. This is called parallel venation. Question number C, write down the differences between A and B. You have to differentiate it, figure number A and figure number B. Now we will discuss. Differences between A and B are given below. A, monocot, this is monocot plant, and B, dicot, this is dicot plant. Differentiated, number one, stem is unbranched and stem is branched. Here in the figure number A, their stem is not branched, but their stem is branched. Here is the branch. Leaves, differentiate number two, leaves with parallel venation. Their leaves are in parallel venation, but their leaves are reticulate venation. Number three, flowers trimerous, flowers pentamerous. In their flower, there are only three petals and they have five petals. Pollen with single pore, pollen with three pores, secondary growth absent, secondary growth often present. Secondary growth means when plants grow in white, they are called secondary growth. in the tree of coconut tree, here their secondary growth is absent, but in banyan tree, in case of banyan tree, their secondary growth is present. Question number D, write down the importance of A in your life. Now you have to write the importance of coconut in your life. Now we will read the answer. Number D, in the stem as indicated by the figure A is a coconut tree. Some of its importance is given below. Number 1, it is a green fruit which contains juicy endosperm. Number 2, it is delicious and nutritious. Number 3, shampoo and several cosmetics are produced from coconut oil. Number 4, coconut oil used for hair growth. 5, its endosperm is used in making different types of delicious food. We make different kinds of delicious mouth-watering food by its endosperm. Number 6, coconut juice is very popular in summer. We drink coconut water in summer. Number 7, the stem and leaf of this tree is used as a fuel. Number 8, the leaves of this tree are used as the shade of heart. 9, the skin of coconut fruit is also used in making ropes, mattress and other furnitures. Number 10, coconut leaves are used for making brooms, which is used to clean houses. Number 11, this fruit is used for making sweets. Number 12, coconut and coconut milk are both used as a garnish in several traditional dishes. We use this coconut and coconut milk for different kind of delicious dishes. Now our homework is homework number 7, CQ number 2, C. My dear students, I hope you understood our today's class. You will stay at home, abide by your parents, keep well. Till then, Allah Hafiz and Assalamu Alaikum.